Hey, hello everyone, welcome back. And finally, after a long time, I'm back with another adventure of Kenneth Anderson. And this time, I'm following up on a story called as Man-Eater of Jaulgiri. So this entire story actually is in the book Nine Man-Eaters and One Rogue, which was published in 1954. And I guess this incident probably took place in 1940s. So that's a guess. And the man-eater here is in question was a tigress, which had killed around 15 people by the time Kenneth actually arrived in Jaulgiri and started to look for it in and around Jaulgiri. So the entire area where the tigress roamed was from Jaulgiri to Shulagunta, or also it's written as Sulaikunta in the book, and then another place, Anchetti, and then all the way till Gundalam. Gundalam was actually a cattle patti, where cattle used to be kept those days inside the forest. So I don't think that place exists now. Forest departments have removed the cattle patties. So, but that was a area where the man-eating tigress was there, and that's the place where Kenneth's adventure took place. So yeah, I'm now currently, I've crossed Marlwadi Dam, and I'm heading towards Jaulgiri, which is on that side. So I've just crossed Banaratta National Park, but I'll be crossing the Tamil Nadu forest now and entering Jaulgiri. And while I do that, I will let you see the topography of this region on the map. So check this out. This is the Kaveri North Wildlife Sanctuary, Jaulgiri Range. Okay. So this is the Tamil Nadu Hosur section. This is the map given by Kenneth Anderson in the book. So we have Jaulgiri marked here, and then Sulaikunta, Anchetti, and Gundalam, which is a cattle patti. And I have opened the same in Google Maps here, so we can see Jaulgiri. Sulaikunta is around here, and then we have Anchetti here, and Gundalam is a cattle patti which was there in the forest. So I'll try to show where exactly it was. And the path from Jaulgiri to Sulaikunta, so if I can zoom in here, so we still have this is the path which I'll have to take to reach Sulaikunta. And then you can see a river in the valley here called as Hebbe Halla River. So we have that valley here where this river flows. And one way to identify Gundalam is, you can see the river actually passes right next to Anchetti in the maps. So if we look closely, we have this river that Hebbe Halla actually crosses here, right next to Anchetti. And the footpath from Gundalam actually converged at Anchetti, and it actually crossed the river here. So this is a footpath that actually crosses this river and reaches Anchetti. And if you follow this footpath down, this actually goes into the jungle, and it actually splits here and it reaches a place over here. So, and if you see in the maps again, this river which after crossing Anchetti again reaches Gundalam. So see the river here, it comes again right next to this area on the maps. And for some reason, this one region is devoid of all trees
if you look at the surrounding areas, it's all forest but except this one region, which makes me believe this was indeed Gundalam cattle patti, but it's probably cleared off by the forest department now. But yeah, nevertheless, can't be very sure because there is no access to reach this place as of now. It's in the forest, but yeah, sometime later, hopefully can reach this place. But yeah, this is the landscape where the man-eating tiger of Jaulgiri had its, beat.
So there's a nice observation deck here to overlook the waterhole on the other side. Probably would be a good place to spend some time. Okay, this seems to be the forest office of Jaulgiri. It's obviously renovated. The reason I came here is the tigress had killed a watchman at this very guest house. So it's quite near the forest. So that's one incident in Jaulgiri. So I'm now heading towards Sulekunta or Shulagunta. And I now see that there is, again I have to cross the same stretch, another stretch of Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary. Because of the rains, the forests are absolutely green. On the way, Jelli Mariamma Temple. This seems to be a very, very old temple.
So my first impressions were, Kenneth actually shot the tiger near a temple. So I thought probably Jelli Mariamma temple behind me was the temple where he actually shot it first. But then I realized he has clearly mentioned the temple was at Shulagunta. He didn't mention it. It's, halfway through to Jaulgiri, and this place is only 5 kilometers from Jaulgiri, and he clearly mentioned it's 7 miles from the temple to Jaulgiri, so that means around 10 to 11 kilometers. So I guess the temple has to be somewhere in Sulekunta itself, and this is not the one. So while I now continue riding towards Shulagunta or Sulekunta, I will show you what could be the potential temples and the area where the temple must be located on the maps.
As you can see, Kenneth marked the location where the tiger was killed slightly outside of Sulekunta. And if I look at that now in Google Maps, I'll have to zoom in here. This is the village, and there is one temple, Basveshwara Swami temple, right inside the village, but I'm not sure if this is the one because it is right inside the village. And he says the temple was inside the forest. But then again, we don't know how this place was 80 years back. Pechuraya Swami temple seems to be closer to the forest. And another thing is Muthuraya Swami temple. This also seems to be closer to the forest, but is slightly outside of the village. So probably I'll have to search for the temple around this location.
Kenneth has mentioned about this river in the valley. He has marked Hebbe Halla River. So I just took a detour from the main road to check this out. So that's the river. There's a river in the valley over there. Beautiful landscape here. There's actually, while heading towards Sulagunta, there is valley on both sides. This seems to be a plateau. There's a valley on that side, and then there is a valley on this side. I'm on the way to Sulagunta, and I see this temple just before Sulagunta. So I need to check if how old and if this temple is. There is a peepal tree as mentioned by Kenneth in front of this temple, but idu hale devasthana iddu adu odad kattirada howda ah odad kattiyara nodi kallu appo kanustide idu mara hosada athwa ee salpa chikkadu hosada iddangide idu ಅದರ ಮುಂಚೆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಮರ ಏನ ಇತ್ತ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರಿ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 80 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ನಾಟ್ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ Come up here as well. It's such a beautiful place, and yeah, that's where you get the stones, precious stones. And that's where they start mining. Unfortunately. Just stunning view here. Not sure what symbol that is. This looks like a recent building, but still demolished.
Looking at all the cut rocks here, I feel, I mean, this road actually on the maps it goes to the mines. So maybe this structure, all this structure, were built to support the people who worked in the mine. So that's another possibility, and it looks like the mine is not functional now. It's good if that's the case. So yeah, but my search continues. I'll ride a little further and see if I can see any other temples. Kenneth actually shot the tiger from on top of a tamarind tree. There are a lot of tamarind trees here. You can see one there, but yeah, unless I can figure out the temple, there's no point in finding a tamarind tree.
ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಊರಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ್ದದು ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನ, ಇದು ಬಸವೇಶ್ವರ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನ ಇದೆಯಾ? ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಏನು ಹಳ್ಳಿ ಮರ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ತುಂಬಾ ಹಳೇದೇನಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಹಳೇದಿರೋದು ಗೊತ್ತೂ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಈಗಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಇದು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ ಕಷ್ಟನೇ ಇದೆ ಹಂಗಾರೆ. ಸರಿ ಇವ್ರೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್. ಹಂಗಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವೇನು ಇಲ್ಲೇ
ಓ
ಯಾವ ಗಾಡಿ ಇದೆ? ಓ, ಮೈನ್ ಗಾಡಿಗಳ ಮೇಲಿದೆಯಾ? ಓ, ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ಕೋತಿರ್ತೀರಾ? ಸರಿ.
ಸೊ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಮೆಟ್ ಅ ವಿಲೇಜರ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಬೈ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೀ ಸೇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಸಿಟೆಡ್. ಹೀ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ರಿಯಲಿ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ರಿಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟೆಡ್. ಫರ್ದರ್ ಆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯೂ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಹೀ ಸೇಸ್, ಆಲ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ನೌ, ನನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಓಲ್ಡ್, ವಿಚ್ ಡೇಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು 1940s. ಸೊ
I have my doubts if I'm going to be able to find, if I will be able to find this temple. Story of this Jaulgiri Manitar, he had an amazing adventure, you know, much down the road at Anchetti. So what exactly happened is, near a hamlet of Anchetti, a person was killed and Kenneth immediately went there. And they entered the forest to find the remains of the person. And then, you know, the tigress had taken that person into a stream bed or a nalla, and from that nalla he actually started tracing that, and he eventually found the remains of the person near a big rock, and he decided to spend the night on top of the rock and try to shoot the tiger. And he had the most thrilling experience that night, because the tiger did not come from where he expected, but it came from behind him. So that's for you to read in the story, but it was super thrilling adventure of his that he had there. So, and I think I am able to sort of locate where exactly that incident happened, but I'm not going to anyway. I can show you that on the maps, but I cannot go there anyway because it's inside the forest. And someday, hopefully, we are getting forest department permission. Probably, I can try and do that. But for now, I'll show you that place on the maps. And in the meantime, I'll continue to see if there is any other old temples here nearby. And this, as I had guessed, this is mines, and he confirmed that the mines have stopped here for good from the past 3 years. And the mines were here apparently for around 30 years, it seems. So for now, mining has stopped here.
Somewhere around here was that hamlet where that incident took place, and he eventually tracked down, he went down the stream. He says he actually reached a nalla bed where the tiger had carried its victim. So if you can zoom in, you can see a stream bed that is passing here. He eventually tracked it to this stream bed, and then he says he actually walked along the stream bed and across two bends. So this could be the two bends that he took, and wherein he says there was a low outcrop of rocks in the nalla bed itself. Like you can see here, a lot of rocks here. So this potentially was the place where Kenneth the hunter himself became almost hunted during his night stay at this place. But yeah, like you can see, this is inside Anchetti forest and definitely not accessible for now at least.
So this is Shulagunda. Sulekunta, as mentioned in the book. En kadlekai aagthira? ಬಟಾಣಿ ಅವರೇಕಾಳ ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿಸಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೈನ್ಸ್ ದೇವ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಪ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪುಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ Can't ride the last part. I mean, the bike won't go, so we'll have to walk the last part. So this is the temple. And this looks like it's properly, I don't know, maybe 300-400 years old tree. Look at the roots of this tree. Okay, spoke to that wonderful lady. She says apparently this temple is just 10 years old. And yeah, so all my assumptions went for a toss. So she says there is one more temple, Jedar Muniyappa temple, which is a really, really old one, and in the right direction where Kenneth had marked it. So that's where I'm headed now.
Jedar Muniyappa inge na? ಈ ದಾರಿ ಹೋಗತ್ತಮ್ಮ ಸರಿ ಸರ್ ಏನು ಇವ್ರೇದು ಬೇಡ್ರ ಮುನಿಯಪ್ಪ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನನ ಬೇಡ್ರ ಮುನಿಯಪ್ಪನ ಇದು ಹಳೆ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೊಸದಾಗಿ ಕಟ್ಟಿದಂಗಿದೆ ಹಳೇದೇನಾ ಹೊಸ ಪೇಂಟ್ ಹೊಡೆದೀರಾ ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಳೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಳೇದು ಇವರೇ ಇದು ಒಂದು 80-100 ವರ್ಷ ಹಳೇದ ಅಂತ ಇದೇ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದಂಗಾರೆ ಇದ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಇದೆ ಅರಳಿ ಮರ ಅಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಯಾವ್ದು ಮಾರಿಯಮ್ಮ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನ ರಾಣಮ್ಮ ಅದು ಹಳೇದ ಅದ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಇದೆಯಾ ಅರಳಿ ಮರ ಒಂದೇನಾದ್ರು ಇದೆಯಾ ಬಾವಿ ಇದೆಯಾ ಇದ್ರ ಇದ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಬಾವಿ ಇದೆಯಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇದೆಯಾ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂಥರ ಕೆರೆ ತರ ಇದು ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಇದು ಈ ಅರಳಿ ಮರ ಏನು ಇದು ಗಾತ್ರ ತುಂಬಾ ದಪ್ಪ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಳೇದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ತುಂಬಾ ಹಳೇದಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ ಅಂತ ಅದು ಗಾತ್ರ ದಪ್ಪ ಆಗತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ ಇನ್ನು ಅಂದ್ರೆ 100 ವರ್ಷ ಹಳೇದ ಅನ್ನೋಂಗ ಅನಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಇರ್ಬೋದಾ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿದೆ ಪೆಂಚುರಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅದರಿಂದನೂ ಒಂದು ಅರಳಿ ಅರಳಿ ಮರ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ ಆಲದ ಮರ ಥರ ಇದೆ ಅದು ಅದರಿಂದ
ಫೌಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅದರ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ದ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಗೈಡೆಡ್ ಮೀ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಕೆನೆತ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಸೀಮ್ಸ್ ಬಿ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಟ್ರೀ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ದ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ The people tree doesn't look to be very old for me. The one I saw near Penchurayaswamy temple, that's a really, really old tree. But this one is not. Or at least it does not look like. Because Kenneth mentioned the temple priest remains were found within the huge roots of the tree. This one, and this one is right next to the temple as well. Which is giving me doubts because there he said the peepal tree was 30 yards in the book it's mentioned it's around 30 yards from the temple so I doubt this is the one as well
ಇದು ಸುಮಾರು 500 ವರ್ಷದ ಹಿಂದಿನದು
500 ವರ್ಷ ಹಳೆ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನ
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಮುತ್ತಾತ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಂತೆ
ಹೌದಾ
ಆವಾಗ ಇದು ಊರಿತ್ತಂತೆ ಇದು ಇದು ತೀರಾ ಊರಿತ್ತಂತೆ ಇದು ಊರಿದ್ದಾಗ ಅವರು ತೀರೋದ ಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಮ ತಾತ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ನಮ್ಮ ತಾತ ತೀರೋದ ಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ
ಸೊ ಯಾರನ್ನು ಹುಲಿ ತಿಂದಿದ್ದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದು ಹತ್ರ ಇಲ್ಲ
ಹುಲಿ ತಿಂದಿದ್ದು ಅಂತೆ ಯಾವುದು ಇಲ್ಲ
ಏಯ್ ಚಿಕ್ಕದ ಕರು ಇದು ಓನ
ಏನು ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ
ಅಲ್ಲ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಇದು ಹಳೆ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನ ಇದೊಂದು ಆದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಕಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಕಟ್ಟಿರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಅವ್ರು ಬರ್ದಿರೋದ್ ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲೇ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಆವಾಗ್ಲೇ 1940 ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಇದು ಅಂತಲ್ಲ ಯಾ ಆ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ಇತ್ತು ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರು ಕೂತಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ
ಸೊ ಯಾ ದಿಸ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟರ್ನ್ ಔಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅನದರ್ ಡೆಡ್ ಎಂಡ್ So I doubt that's the temple. So only things that is feasible is one is Penchuraya Swami which I visited and the other one is the Anjaneya Swami temple which I'm going to visit again now. That's just out of Shulagunta as marked in the book. So, but then the peepal tree over there is it's a little new one so maybe the old one was cut or whatever happened so we'll never know and there doesn't seem to be a well also there in both the places but yeah
in 80 years a lot of things would have changed, and some secrets will never be revealed, and looks like this is one of them which probably will remain with Kenneth. Now, as a parting note, I want to add, I mean, you might be curious as to why exactly did this tigress become man-eater in this area. So one thing that happened was a sports hunter actually tried killing it, but eventually he just ended just injuring it, and which is why it actually turned a man-eater. Otherwise, tigers, they usually don't look for humans. They don't look at humans as prey. Climbed up a tamarind tree on the next morning, and he made a male tiger's call, and the tigress responded, came near the tree, and he was ready to shoot it, and he shot it from on top of that tree. So that was the main reason I was searching for that temple, was to then next try and identify this tamarind tree, which is around 400 meters from the temple.
Back at this temple, Anjaneya Swami temple, but one thing is the tree is new, it's not an old tree here. Maybe it was newly planted. I'll see. I have noted down the distance.
Well, if the Anjaneya Swami temple which I just visited, if that is indeed the temple, if at all that's the temple, then I found a couple of tamarind trees. This one is right on the road towards Jaulgiri, and this seems to be a pretty old tamarind tree, and this is around 600 meters from that temple. I'd be really excited if this is actually the tree from where he shot the tiger. Yeah, but then not very sure about it. Both Venchuraya Swami temple as well as this temple both seems to match half the description that he mentioned about the temple. But nevertheless, coming here on this adventure was really fun, even though I was really not able to pinpoint exact temple and the exact tree where he shot the tiger. But it's okay, there are a lot other things that I got to know about it. But yeah, considering this was the tree, it's a nice place. Just guessing this was the tree, I think it's a nice place to end this vlog from this point. And guess what? Just I was about to leave, return back to Bangalore, and I just happened to meet an old man of the village who said there's another old temple just where I had parked my bike. So I just took a deviation from the road, and there is another old temple here. He says this is an Anjaneya Hanuman temple, and he says this is again a very old temple. And guess what, there is one in a peepal tree right around 20 yards from this place. There's a peepal tree, so it's not a very old one, but yeah, there is a peepal tree, just to add to the confusion. And like Kenneth said, he said he had to traverse a valley before reaching the place, so there's a valley right behind this. So if you have to come from probably Jaulgiri through the valley, maybe that's the valley you'll have to cross and come. So this may as well be the place. So there are three likely temples where near which Kenneth actually shot this tiger. There may be more, but there's at least three for now. So yeah, with that, I'm truly now heading back home, and I'll see you on my next adventure. Until then, take care, see you, bye.